Please subscribe to this channel and also tap the notification bell in order for you not to miss out on any of our videos. COVID gate, cabinet reshuffle, CEMAC, African Cup of Nations. The shirts are piling up on the table of the head of state, who has been absent from the country since July 11th. 1 month and 2 days after his departure from Cameroon for a short private stay in Europe, and despite the pressure from the Brigade Anti-Sardina to leave the Intercontinental Hotel in Geneva, the President of the Republic is still in Switzerland. It should not be long before Paul Biya reaches Yaoundé, where he is supposed to welcome in his capacity as current President of the Conference of Head of States of the Central African Economic and Monetary Community, his peers on August 18 to discuss issues relating to the economic recovery of the sub-region, which remains facing the triple shock of the fall on oil price, the disintegration of the security situation, and the COVID-19 pandemic. Information about the holding of this summit was revealed on August 10 in Douala, on the sidelines of the extraordinary session of the Conference of Ministers of Economic Union of Central Africa. This meeting, which could lay the groundwork for the much-heralded merger of the Economic Community of Central African States and CEMAC, will certainly take place. Paul Biya could consider chairing it from Geneva. It is not only the subject which preoccupies the head of state and which obliges him to shorten his stay in the Swiss capital. On his table, there are also the files of the management of 180 billion franc CFA intended for the response against the coronavirus. It obsesses donors all the more that during the 9th session of the steering committee of the dialogue platform on public finance, which was held this week in Yaoundé, the head of the European Union, the delegation in Cameroon, the Swiss, Philippe Van Damme, said without turns of language to the Minister of Finance, Louis Paul Motaze, that it is of the utmost importance that the audit report of these funds be published as soon as possible, and that a parliamentary debate finally take place on the management of this envelope in order to draw the administrative and judicial conclusions which are required. For the European diplomat, meeting these requirements will confirm that the government's determination for greater transparency and accountability in the management of public funds. The stay of Paul Biya in Switzerland could, for some, have allowed him to refine his future government expected since the end of the double legislative and municipal elections of 2020. In this case, he would have to kill two birds with one stone, as many believe that the current government team is at the end of its rope and is now unable to find solutions to the multifaceted crisis that Cameroon has been going through for several years. A cabinet reshuffle would also make it possible to set this sort of government crisis in which the country is plunged and which manifests itself through clashes in the public square between ministers. One of the emergencies on which Paul Biya should also look upon his return to the capital relates to the organization of the African Cup of Nations. With less than 6 months of the kickoff of the competition, Cameroon is unable to say that they are 100% ready. At the moment, the Olembe Stadium, which is supposed to host the opening and the final of the CAN, is not ready. The same goes for that of the Japuma in Douala, where there is still the problems of development and access of roads. Alongside these questions, there is the no less nagging question of the development of routes to facilitate traffic flow during the competition, especially in Yaoundé and Douala. Obviously, the Anglophone crisis, which has again left several families in mourning in recent weeks and which continues to bleed the state coffers dry more and more than ever, should be at the heart of the presidential concerns, as should the fight against Boko Haram.